Well, this is about how I am usually when I'm outside, because at night when I take the dogs out, I see little white particles coming down, even with clear skies, constantly. Pollen, if it's pollen, is fine. But I don't believe it when I see stuff like this up in the sky. Let me see if I can get my... Those aren't clouds, although a lot of people think they are. It might, well, I should, let me clarify that. There are some clouds mixed with some of that chemtrail stuff up there. You see how that real thin layered stuff that's pulled out like cotton candy? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you're breathing it. I limit myself as much as I can to being outside for one, which is might be what they want, but when I'm out here, generally, I have a mask on my face. At night when I take the dogs out, I have a mask on my face. In the mornings, I have a mask on my face. I'm here. I do not always wear it if I go someplace, but when I'm outside, I'd say about 70% of the time I have a mask on my face. And, you know, I've been fairly healthy. You know, my wife has had a virus with her stomach twice, got sick twice. Other than doing this, I do ingest colloidal silver. And, you know, I mean, I just try to do the things I can to keep myself from being sick. I think maybe I might have a brief cough one time in the last year. That's a whole year, too. Okay, so... I'm outside. I was out in the garden last year, and then I was outside and about with some other things around the house here. And but, you know, I use the precautions of a mask on in the mornings, in the evenings. If I go out, it would be about the only time I don't have a mask, because with all these stupid idiots out there right now, you wear a mask and go into a store, and they're like, oh, my God, you know, which I really don't give a shit myself. But, you know, it's like I say, I don't go out that much to stores even, so... my mother passed away in December on the 28th at 3:49 p.m. And the blessing of a small insurance, very small, between three sons, it's helped tremendously. I feel a lot more prepared than I know 90% of you people, or maybe even a larger number than that. So I keep encouraging people to go out and get some canned vegetables at the very least, which I have, plus I have seeds. Plus I have, I can't really see it too good over there. My garden's gotta be, I have to order some topsoil maybe, if I can get some, make sure the topsoil comes from a reputable place. But, hold on here. Let me go out here and show like it was yesterday. I'm gonna whiten it a little bit. And, I might take it about another foot or so in both directions also. East is at that end. Oh, wow. This yard is very uneven, so I tripped a little bit. At that end of the garden is east. At this end is west. Almost due east and due west. With the seasons, though, it's off a little bit right at the moment. But, as you see the lighter part of the grass here. It's about almost 3 feet off to this side over here, to the south side. That's going to be cut up. And I marked it with just a couple sticks a couple days ago, but I'm going to go probably a little bit further on the other side, on the north side. You see the sticks down there in the yard. I can't see in this viewfinder with the sun right there. You see, I'm going to go a little bit further out. A little further away, which would be north that way. So probably about where that grass, or actually those are vines from the garden. There's still some in here. I got it chopped up with a tiller and then get about a ton or so of soil dumped out here by March. I get some worms to throw out here to help with the fertilization of excrement. And then I'm building my compost back there next to the shed. And get some red wigglers, they call them, to help break down the compost, plus with the excrement and whatnot of the worm, the waste. I have my compost, and I have this out here And then I'll plant probably about the third week of March, second week of March. So right now it is February 12th, 2013, is approximately 8:55 a.m. Central Time. So I would suggest to everybody, if you don't start preparing within the next month or so, you pretty much may be screwed. So they're planning on something big. That's why they want to disarm the people. Because we won't be throwing rocks. You know, we're not going to be throwing rocks like the people in other third world countries. Because, you know, we're pretty much there, almost there. Not quite that extreme, but we're getting there very fast. And people are not paying attention to it because the media are lying to you and telling you a bunch of bull. But you don't want to believe it. I know it's horrific, but, you know, you get what you deserve, okay? So I'm asking you people, please, to try. Make a small garden around your house or whatever. I've got some areas around the house where I'm going to grow peppers and tomatoes. Excluding this right here. And this will have probably about 6 to 7 rows in it. It's about 30 feet long by about 15 feet, 15 or 20 feet across, about 40 feet long. So I don't even have the exact measurements, which is pretty bad. But anyway, it'll be more than enough for us for the year, but we're gonna store it too. So I suggest you do the same. Stay as safe as you can. Get yourself what you need for your family. Stop depending on the government. These criminals that are running, that they call themselves the government, they don't care about you, man. You're stupid if you keep believing their lies. Everybody stay safe.